really, really lovely, fun experience.
Little Anteater Balls.
Yes, it's going to conclude with luxury comedy, the next attempt. What is different about Series 2? Everything. It's a story now, there's stories. So there's something to follow, each one has a story.
And Noel is kind of more of a normal character in some ways. He's more of a sort of grounded character.
That is the most embarrassing that I've ever seen.
Well, don't read it then, Big Nose.
And what is wrong with you? You're so uncool, Bigger Nose.
Oh, there's lots of things different about Series 2 of Noel's show. Mostly I'm just much, much better in Series 2 than I know.
I do all the coffees, I do all the frappuccino, I just want to scrub tables. Yeah. He's a bit of a diva, actually.
I'm not disagreeing with you in any way.
What a school teacher, he's a chocolate biscuit of interest.
Yeah. To try and make the coffee shop look like a real place so that the weirdness could happen in smaller chunks and be woven into a narrative so that they'd have more impact and effect. And I didn't want to wear makeup on my face and be some sort of weird wizard. I wanted to be a bloke working in a coffee shop where all this weird stuff's happening in his own fantasy world, but his fantasy world's out of control.
The concept for this was, in the original script, was that this was an airport cafe set on the edge of a volcano in Hawaii, so it was kind of a weird brief. And also we wanted to ring the differences between this series and the last series. So the last series, I guess the set was a bit fantasy, a bit surreal. This one had to be a bit more grounded in reality. So we, although it's on the edge of a volcano, we wanted to keep the cafe interior looking kind of stylish, but real looking. So there's a difference. Still quite colourful and quite bright.
The whole thing has a kind of 70s vibe to it.
The colours are important, and they kind of link up with the costumes too. So there's the whole thing's a kind of homogenous look, homogenous style.
Have you ever made a coffee?
No. What is coffee?
I teach you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You can't operate the
machine.
There's a machine in there.
I worked for
There's a machine in there. You don't even
it's
know how
working.
To operate it.
It's not working. It doesn't work.
You didn't even know what to do. The right
yes,
things
I did.
To do. I've been a barrister.
If it worked.
In real life, I've been
worked.
A barrister.
You've been a barrister? What, a legal barrister?
Yeah.
I've been
coffee.
A barista, you've been a barrister. There's a difference.
I've been making coffee for the lawyers.
I wouldn't, if you were in charge of my case, I'd go straight down.
Would I send you down?
No! No, that's not a good picture, you doing that, funny.
What's happened to your arm now?
It's got a little
really weird.
We need your
right,
arm.
Hands up, that's it.
Roy Circles is in the coffee shop on the shelf, Neil Cutts, a local policeman, Fancy Man is in reality and we call him sometimes. Joe Ramone is on the plasticine part of the island, it's set on an island in Hawaii now, so it's like a touristy coffee shop.
As you know, I have a vested interest in all things fantastical, hence my name, Fantasy Man. Fancy man.
7, 8, 8, 1, common mark. I'm getting right in there.
Is this high enough for you, Nigel?
Yeah, it's good. Okay, alright.
First obvious question, what are you doing?
In my life, or just in general? this is a character called Paul Panther. It's sort of maybe the body though, because the head's going to be animated, but my eyes are going to be put in. He's an internet sensation. So he remakes Elvis films on his mobile phone using himself and two sock puppets. And he's got like 20 million YouTube hits. The whole episode's about, when you watch stuff on the internet, how can you judge whether it's good or not? Even if it's got loads of sort of... If something's got 10 million hits, you tend to think, oh, this must be good. And then you watch it and go, wow, is it good? I can't work it out. So it's like sort of art brute. It's like sort of something really shoddy about it. Charming about it because it's not slick and it's not commercial, it's just he does it for himself, puts him on there, no one knows who he is, they don't know if he can speak, they don't know where he comes from, and yet he's seemingly got quite a big following.
Is this representing somebody?
It's a metaphor for the show. It was quite hard to do because our show's sort of a bit like that in a way, a bit sort of lo-fi and idiotic.
That's it, okay, that's good.
And here we go.
Got some good cameos as well. We've got Steve Oram, we've got Richard Iwadi, we've got Fulcher, we've got Stuart Silver, we've got Baronka, we've got Arnau, we've got some really good people in it this time. So, and I've tried not to play everyone this time, so it's nice because I'm not playing opposite myself so much. I am still doing it a little bit, but really nice to have Iwadi doing some stuff and Fulcher and stuff. So
keeps the family alive.
Yeah, the Bush family. Farnaby's doing a bit, so some really good people in it.
I'm playing George Orwell, obviously, and he gets evicted from fantasy world into reality.
I'm working in a cafe now.
I had someone arrive for an interview in a very strange way. And the interview was short but sweet. And he got the job. Yeah, he's not very good, is he? He's rubbish.
Howling, Burning Beaches, Sammy. Two of the coolest Camden kids I know, dressed like absolute freaks.
There's builders today.
In a cap.
Yeah. I'm quite typecast. Everything that Noel's had me involved in, I end up calling him a prick, which is good fun. So I do that quite a lot anyway when I'm around.
That's not your real hair, is it?
Like, no, it's not.
No. I was going to say, you've got long hair.
Beautiful locks down to about here.
Where's it gone?
They've tied it all up for me. I just sent a picture back to our lead guitarist, Rev, and I've told him that I've had my hair chopped like this. And we've got a photo shoot coming up and he's starting to shit himself. I won't tell him the truth either.
We have been coffee shop customers.
Yeah, very important role. Talking about boys.
Festivals.
Dreams.
Murdering dreams and sexy dreams. And we've discovered that we can lip read. So we actually had a conversation. A silent
conversation. Real conversation.
Skills for life.
Can you do it right now?
I mean, the vibe is always the same. We all have a really fun time. Everyone's really nice. Me and Mike aren't very good at listening and slightly moronic with... I feel like I use that word, sort of not as good at imagining things that aren't there or sort of getting our lefts and rights. But I think there has, because we had a long rehearsal period, we all feel very in it together and we all sort of really care about it working and the story being good. And I feel like it's a really united group of people. And also it feels even more like a family this time, like, you know, we're the parents of these weird anteater and very strange... and there's quite a lot of laughing like that goes on. Battlegrass. You're laughing at, you're missing out. I need the loo door open in case I'm going to miss out.
Or I could do that thing you always wanted.
Really?
Might be easier to do in water.
This is going to sound ridiculous because it's the best that come over. I watched a lot of Cheers because there's a lot of four-way dialogues because we're in a coffee shop. So quite a hard four-way dialogues. I've only really done two and three, like me and Julian, or me, Julian and Fossil, or me, Julian and a Monster. So four was quite difficult. But you sort of have to be quite snappy with the dialogue with four, because the four people are saying, each have a line each to say one thing, really. The sentence still has to work as a sentence, but with four people, all adding a little bit, so it's quite a specific skill.
This is like the Scum Manifesto all over again.
It looks a bit warm in there.
I can't believe this is how I'm gonna die. Sacrifice to a volcano, it's so uncool.
Why don't you do some of your fashionable begging?
Yeah, I just got a text, it's gone back out again.
What, already?
Yes.
He motivates us all day, he's good. He motivates us and makes us laugh, and then we can have banter on.
That's so kind. They've all been amazing.
They've all been smashing. He's like our dad.
Hello,
Di.
I look after my children.
You're
a fantasy, darling.
You're
a bit warm.
Don't
you
can't
even
know. If we're feeling a bit tired and a bit kind of like low, he always drinks up.
This is a
sanctuary. With my erection. If you were on a desert island and you had one luxury item, what would it be?
Heroin.
Some sort of opium, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Really?
What sort of drug?
What, in tablets or are you needles?
Fine.
How big?
No, not really. Just basically stupid for the sake of it.
How big? Can we put it tonight?
What, the luxury item?
Yeah.
How big though?
huge.
Like you could take a labyrinth with you.
Yeah.
Library.
Well, the film.
British Library. You wouldn't get bored then, would you? That's so boring.
Really,
that's
the point. Of, right, I was quite impressed by that.
All right, I'll take a fur jeep.
I'd take Dolly. If we were, are we all on there together? Or?
No.
That's all you need, surely.
Is that what you want?
Each other. Each other.
Each other.
I would kill you all.
That's good.
Athens!